Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Thursday, June 16th. We may have some rain and even some thunderstorms following us for the morning commute this morning, but our chief meteorologist Dan Zero says eventually that band of rain will end. It'll be a decent afternoon, and then more rain and potential thunderstorms will return for tonight. Should be out of here by tomorrow, and a nice weekend is upcoming. Sunny, but it'll be relatively cool for this time of year. Dan's full forecast on air online at nj1015.com and on our free mobile app. Gas prices continue to drop ever so slightly in the Garden State, but still above $5 a gallon. Here are the latest numbers from AAA this morning. The statewide average, down a penny, $5.04. Shore gas prices remain above $5 in general. Somerset remains the most expensive county at $5.15, but that's down 2 cents this week. The Turnpike and Parkway have upped their prices at rest stops to $5.17 a gallon. And many of you continue to ask about whether Costco can restrict its discount gas sales to members only. And the answer to that question still appears to be yes. We have been asking consumer affairs officials about it for a couple of weeks. They say they can't find any law that would prevent Costco from doing so. There is speculation that New Jersey and Costco struck a private deal in 2004 that forced Costco to sell to everyone, and there never was really any law to cite, so there is nothing to force them to keep selling to non-members in New Jersey. We do have expanded coverage of the story this morning at nj1015.com. 2 million New Jersey property taxpayers are going to be getting direct rebates under a deal that was struck between legislative leaders and Governor Murphy and announced on Wednesday. The $2 billion program comes thanks to flush state coffers, largely because of generous contributions from the federal government. Governor Murphy says this amounts to lowering the roughly $9,300 average property tax bill to $7,800, a level not seen in more than a decade. Murphy, Assembly Speaker Craig Coughlin, Senate President Nicholas Cotari spoke alongside one another in South Brunswick, saying part of the deal includes an agreement to continue the program in the future, meaning it won't be just a one-shot relief program, but no details on how to fund that have been provided by either side so far. Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell is vowing to continue to do everything that he can, along with the Fed, to try and fight inflationary figures that are the highest they've been in 40 years. A worse-than-expected inflation report for May helped spur the Fed to raise interest rates by 0.75 point and signal more large rate hikes are likely coming. Economic history suggests that aggressive, growth-killing rate hikes could be necessary to finally control inflation, but it typically is a prescription for recession. So what does the Fed hike mean to you? From credit card interest to the interest rate you'll pay on home mortgages, it is likely to cost you more in New Jersey, at least in the short term. Real estate expert Jeff Otto says we've already seen declining home sales in the Garden State for the past 8 months. This new rate hike will simply accelerate the slowdown, and he says we can expect the cost of apartment living in the Garden State to go up. With crowds continuing to build at the shore, an Ocean County town is going to implement for the third year in a row a youth curfew. Toms River telling teens be home by a certain time under penalty of a disorderly person's offense. Unaccompanied minors have been given an extra hour this year. The nightly curfew runs from 11 p.m. until 5 a.m. through the end of September. The police chief says the curfew is designed to address destructive behavior experienced on both public and private property with large groups of juveniles. We are also monitoring social media chatter of another pop-up party scheduled in Asbury Park for this weekend. Asbury may be the latest to go to court to try to stop that pop-up party. I write more about that this morning at nj1015.com. Atlantic City casino workers are overwhelmingly supportive of a walkout over the July 4th weekend. 96% of members voting to authorize the strike during Wednesday's voting. Members of Local 54 of the Unite Here union could potentially walk out over the July 4th weekend if new contracts with the gaming halls are not reached. Ford is recalling nearly 3 million vehicles, which if they were left in the wrong gear could simply roll away, injuring you or somebody else. The recall affects the Escape, C-Max, Fusion, and Transit Connect. Starting with the 2013 model year, the transmission may indicate the vehicle's been shifted into park, even if it hasn't, causing a rollaway. Demand for recreational weed remains strong, evidenced by the long lines outside of three new dispensaries that opened in the Garden State. Two recreational sales on Wednesday that included Woodbridge, the mayor, and other local officials on hand welcoming the crowds. New Jersey has been doing banner business in the recreational weed market since sales began just about a month ago. How has the sale of weed impacted the Garden State? Join me tonight for a special town hall broadcast, Growing Weed in the Garden State. My guests include cannabis experts, law enforcement, business leaders, and more as we examine the long road to legal weed and whether it's been good or bad for New Jersey. That's tonight at 7 on air and live right here on Facebook. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's First News for this Thursday, June 16th. Have a great day.